Utility crews arriving here at the scene of this downed power line reported by Stevens County Fire District 1 earlier this morning. There's a lot of trees that are really susceptible to snapping. A lot of them have been burned. They're very dry. In fact, if you look just over there, you can see some of those swaying in the wind, and it looks like they'll be there much longer.
Trees that might not make it through another round of harsh winds. We saw more trees like that in the Nine Mile Falls area. This power line was just off Villier Road near Long Lake. Authorities there reminding people to steer clear of those types of hazards and report them immediately. Utility crews were prepared for the worst and hoping for the best. Most of this country is Inland Power's territory. They had crews on standby for more power outages. Early this morning, around 1,200 customers were in the dark, much busier than Avista, who only had a few hundred outages from last night's storm. Spokesperson Debbie Simic says crews are ready for a long weekend. While the utility learned lessons from Windstorm 2015, they were as prepared as they could have been, all thanks to a big change in the way they respond to major disasters.
We had implemented the incident command system structure, and that's similar to what police and fire also use. We implemented that in 2014. So this was 2015 was a big test of that, and it proved to us that that system works well.
After a rainy, gusty morning, the clouds cleared briefly and gave us just a little taste of autumn sunshine. The Inland Northwest now hunkering down for a long, wet weekend. Reporting in Spokane, Casey Lund, KXLY 4 News.